and ever and unto ages of ages.
Against me. I am counsel with them that go down into the pit and become as a man without home, being among the dead like the bodies of the slain that sink in the grave, whom thou rememberest no more, they are cut off from thy hand. They lay me in the lowest pit of darkness and in the shadow of death. Against me is thy anger made strong, and all thy billows hast thou brought upon me. Thou hast removed my friends apart from me, and that they have made me an abomination unto themselves. I have been delivered up and have not come forth. My hands are grown weak from poverty. I have cried unto thee, O Lord, the whole day long. I have stretched out my hands unto thee. They for the dead will thou work wonders, or shall physicians raise them up, that they may give thanks unto thee. They shall lay in their graves, and of thy mercy with thy truth and thy destruction. They shall thy wonders be known in that darkness, and thy righteousness in that land that is forgotten. But as for me and thee, O Lord, have I cried, and in the morning shall my prayer come before thee. Wherefore, O Lord, didst thou cast off my soul, and finish away thy face from me. A poor man am I, and in troubles for many years. Yea, having been exalted, I was humbly brought to distress. Thy fears have passed upon me, and thy terrors have slowly troubled me. They came round about me like water all day long, and compassed me about together. Thou hast removed apart from me, friend and neighbor, and mighty fortress, because of my misery. O Lord God of my salvation, by day by cry, if I am before thee, let my prayer come before thee, bow down thy ear to my supplication. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me, bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forgive not all that he hath done for thee, who is gracious to do all thy iniquities, who healeth all thy infirmities, who redeemeth thy life from corruption, who crowneth thee with mercy and compassion, who fulfilleth thy desire with good things, that you should be renewed as the eagles. The Lord performeth deeds of mercy and executeth his judgment for all them that are wrong. He hath made his ways known unto Moses and to the sons of Israel, the things he hath willed. Compassionate and merciful is the Lord, long-suffering and plenteous in mercy. Not unto the end will he be angered, neither unto eternity will he be wroth. Not according to our iniquities hath he dealt with us, neither according to our sins hath he rewarded us, or according to the height of heaven from the earth. The Lord hath made his mercy to prevail over them that fear him. As far as the east is from the west, so far hath he removed our iniquities from us. Like as the Father hath compassion upon the Son, so hath the Lord hath compassion upon them that fear him. For he knoweth wherefore we are made here, to remember that fear of us. As the man that saves us to grass, the flower of the fields will surely blossom forth. For when the rich pass over, then it will be gone, and the love will open those places around. But the mercy of the Lord is given to the eternity upon them that fear him. And his righteousness is upon the sons and sons upon them that keep his testament and embrace the man that see him. The Lord in heaven hath prepared his crown, and his kingdom ruleth over all. Bless the Lord, all ye his angels, mighty in strength, and performeth marvels by the voice of his word. Bless the Lord, all ye his hosts, his ministers that do his will. Bless the Lord, all ye his works in every place of his dominion. Bless the Lord, O my soul. In every place of his dominion, bless the Lord, O my soul. O Lord, you hear my prayer, you hear my supplication in thy truth. Hearken unto me in thy righteousness, and unto that of the judgment of thy servant. For thy sight shall no man that he does apply. For the enemy hath persecuted my soul, he hath humbled my life down to the earth. He hath set me darkness and those that have been long dead, and my spirit within me hath become despondent. Within me my heart is troubled. I remember days of old, I meditated on all thy works. I pondered on the creation of thy hands. I stretched forth my hands to thee. My soul thirsteth after thee like a waterless land. Quickly hear me, O Lord, my spirit is fainted away. Turn not thy face away from me, lest I be like them that go down into the pit. Cause me to fear thy mercy in the morning, for in the end I put my hope. Cause me to know, Lord, the way when I should walk, for in the end lift up my soul. Rescue me from my enemies, O Lord, and to thee have I fled for refuge. Teach me to do thy will, for thou art my God. Thy good spirit shall lead me in the land of righteousness. For thy name's sake, O Lord, shall I put in me. In thy righteousness shall thou bring my soul out of affliction. And in thy mercy shalt thou utterly destroy my enemies. And thou shalt cut off all them that afflict my soul. For I am thy servant. O Lord, give ear to my supplication, and unto God the judgment of thy servant. O Lord, give ear to my supplication, and unto God the judgment of thy servant. Thy good spirit shall lead me in the land of righteousness. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, who both now and ever is reigning to ages. Amen. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. For God and our hope, glory to thee.
In peace let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace from above and for the the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace of the whole world, for the good estate of the holy churches of God, and for the union of all men, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this holy house and for those with faith, reverence, and the fear of God enter therein, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our Father, Metropolitan Joseph, for the venerable priesthood, the diaconate in Christ, for all the clergy and the people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For Metropolitan Paul and Archbishop John, and for their quick release from captivity and safe return, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
President of the United States, for all civil authorities and for armed forces everywhere, especially for Peter, Joshua, Rodney, Adam, Andrew, Benjamin, Thaddeus, Connor, and Skyler, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this city and for every city and land, and for the faithful who dwell therein, for healthful seasons, for abundance of the fruits of the earth, and for peaceful times, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For travelers by sea, by land, and by air, for the sick and the suffering, for captives and for their salvation, for those under persecution for the faith, for our deliverance from all tribulation, wrath, danger, and necessity, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy upon us, and protect us, O God, by your grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Calling to remembrance our all holy immaculate, most blessed and glorious Lady Theotokos, and ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and all our life unto Christ our God.
In the name of the Lord,
all give thanks.
us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
All in your remembrance, our all holy immaculate, most blessed and glorious, Mary. All the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and our whole life unto your Christ our God.
For thine is the might, and thine is the kingdom, and the power and the glory of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
When the tomb of Jesus be opened in peace, wailing, Mary cried unto the tower of the apostles, saying, Come out, ye laborers of the vineyard, and proclaim the words of the resurrection. For the Lord is risen, granting the world great mercy.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Mary Magdalene, O Lord, this time by the tomb and for our weeping. And when she felt thou wast the gardener, she said, Where hast thou given the everlasting love? Where hast thou placed him to sit at the Lord's cherubic throne? And when she saw the Lord, she kept him appearing from fear like death. She cried unto them, Give me my Lord, or else what would be saying? All thou wast the number of them among the dead, and it is praise the dead, Lord, glory to thee.
Hope now and ever, and to age the patience. Amen. Verily, Gideon did picture thy conception of foresight. And David interpreted thy birth giving of the Theotokos, for the word did fall in thy womb as a rain from on the fleece. And so thou didst cause to grant for us Christ our God of salvation to the world without sea, O holy earth and full of grain.
Verily, life is placed in grave, and in seal for Christ the stone, and the soldiers guarded Christ the stick with a stone, a sleeping king, that the Lord rose might his enemies in an invisible way.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Verily, Jonah did come before and make a sign of thy tomb, and Simeon did interpret thy divine resurrection, O deathless Lord. For thou didst descend into the grave as one who is dead. O thou who didst invade the gates of Hades in its rise, create from corruption to the salvation of the world, being master of Christ our God, and didst light to those who are in darkness.
Both now and ever, and unto ages of ages, amen. Pray, O Virgin, thou helpest to thy Son Christ our God, who was willingly nailed upon the cross, and did rise from the dead, that he might save our souls.
Blessed art thou, O Lord, teach me thy statutes. The company of the angels was amazed when they beheld.
ourselves and each other and our whole life unto Christ our God.
Let us pray to the Lord God.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Wisdom, stand upright. Let us hear the Holy Gospel.
Peace be to all.
Unto thy spirit.
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. John.
Glory to thee, O Lord, glory to thee.
Let us be attentive.
On the first day of the week, Mary Magdalene came to the tomb early while it was still dark, and saw that the stone had been taken away from the tomb. So she ran and went to Simon Peter and the other disciple, the one whom Jesus loved, and said to them, "They have taken the Lord out of the tomb, and we do not know where they have laid him." Peter then came out with the other disciple, and they went toward the tomb. They both ran, but the other disciple outran Peter and reached the tomb first. And stooping to look in, he saw the linen cloths lying there, but he did not go in. Then Simon Peter came following him and went into the tomb. He saw the linen cloths lying and the napkin which had been on Jesus' head, not lying with the linen cloths, but rolled up in a place by itself. Then the other disciple who reached the tomb first also went in, and he saw and believed. For as yet they did not know the scripture, that Jesus must rise from the dead. Then the disciples went back to their home.
Glory to thee, O Lord, glory to thee.
And that we have beheld the resurrection of Christ, let us bow down before the Holy Lord Jesus, the only sinless one, thy cross to be the throne of Christ, and thy holy resurrection to be praised and glorified. For thou art our God, and we are in the name of Christ. Gather all upon thy name, but come, O ye faithful, let us share Christ's holy resurrection. For lo, to the cross is joy come into all the world. Ever blessing the Lord, let us sing his resurrection. For in that he endured the cross for us, he has destroyed the death by death.
Mercy on me, O God, according to thy great mercy, according to the multitude of thy compassion, blot out my transgression. Wash me thoroughly from my iniquity, and cleanse me from my sin. For I know my iniquity and my sin is ever before thee. Before me against thee, only have I sinned and done the sinful before thee, that thou mightest be justified in thy words, who thou art our judge. For behold, I was conceived in iniquity and sin, since in my mother Mary. For behold, thou hast loved truth and hid this iniquity, thy wisdom thou hast made manifest unto me. Thou shalt sprinkle me with incense, and I shall be made clean. Thou shalt wash me, and I shall be made whiter than snow. Thou shalt make me to fear joy and gladness, and those that behold they shall rejoice. And when I face away from my sins, the blood of all my iniquities, create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me. Cast me not away from thy presence, and take not thy Holy Spirit from me. Restore unto me the joy of thy salvation, and with thy governing spirit establish me. Then I will keep transgressors thy ways, and the godly shall turn back to thee. Deliver me from blood guiltiness, O God of my salvation. Thy tongue shall rejoice in thy righteousness. O Lord, thou shalt open thy lips, and thy mouth shall declare thy praise. For if thou hast desired sacrifice, thy given, with whole burnt offerings, thou shalt not be pleased. A sacrifice unto God is a broken spirit, a heart that is broken and humble, God will not despise. Do good, O Lord, thy good pleasure to thine, and let the walls of Jerusalem be built up. Then shall God be pleased with the sacrifice of righteousness, with oblation and over its offerings. Then shall they offer the Lord's diploma on the dying altar.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, through the intercessions of the apostles, O thou who art merciful, blot out all the multitude of our transgression.
Intercessions of our all-immaculate Lady Theotokos, never Virgin Mary, hereby the might of the precious and life-giving cross, by the protection of the honorable bodiless powers of heaven, at the supplications of thy honorable glorious prophet Corner Baptist John, of the holy glorious all-lovable apostles Peter and Paul, and of all thy holy apostles, of our fathers among the saints, great our hearts and ecumenical teacher, Hazel the Great, Gregory the Theologian, and John Chrysostom, Athanasios, Cyril and John, the Merciful Patriarchs of Alexandria, Nicholas of Myra, Smyrna, and Demetrius, Nectaris, Pentapolis, the Wonder Worker, of our fathers among the saints, Tegon, Patriarch of Moscow, Raphael, Bishop of Brooklyn, of the holy, glorious, great martyrs, George the Trophimere, Demetrius, the Nurse Streamer, Theodore the soldier, Theodore the general, and Venus the wonder worker, of the higher martyrs, Ignatius. Ignatius, the God bearer of Antioch, Amphos, Eleutherios, of all holy, glorious Greek women martyrs, Barbara, Anastasia, Catherine, Kiriaki, Putini, Marina, Ruska, Venere, of the holy and glorious, right, victorious martyrs, of our venerable and God-bearing fathers, in the ascetic life, St. Barnabas, the patron and protector of this holy community, of the righteous and holy ancestors of God, Joachim and Anna, the higher martyr focus, the higher martyrs, Apollinaris and Vitalis, the bishops of Ravenna, the martyr, Apollinaris of Rome, the holy prophet Ezekiel, whose memory we celebrate today, and of all thy saints, we beseech thee, O most merciful Lord, hearken unto the petitions of the sinners who make our supplications unto thee. Have mercy upon us.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Through the mercy, compassions, and love for mankind of thine only begotten Son, with whom thou art blessed, together with thine all holy good and life-giving Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages.
Yeah.
Let us honor and magnify in song.
My soul is praising the Lord, and my spirit is rejoicing in the Lord. Lord, I am the Lord, and I shall be with you, and your glory is beyond compare, and the seraphim. How could we both sing your song of praise, and not you be there?
For he is holy. Adam is recalled from the dead, the curse is made void, he in the suffering death is slain, and we are itself with life. Wherefore in hymns of praise we cry aloud, blessed art thou, O Christ our God, who is thus wanting glory to thee.
Glory to you, Lord, show us the light.
Master.
Blessed is the kingdom of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen. In peace let us pray to the Lord. For the peace from above and for the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord. For the peace of the whole world, for the good estate of the holy churches of God, and for the union of all men, let us pray to the Lord. For this holy house and for those who have faith, reverence, and the fear of God entered therein, let us pray to the Lord. For our Father, and for God and Joseph, for the venerable priesthood, the diaconate in Christ, for all the clergy and the people, let us pray to the Lord.
Have mercy.
For Metropolitan Paul and Archbishop John, and for their quick release from captivity and safe return, let us pray to the Lord.
Have mercy.
For the President of the United States, for all civil authorities, and for armed forces everywhere, especially for Peter, Joshua, Ronnie, Adam, Benjamin, Thaddeus, Andrew, Skylar, and Connor, let us pray to the Lord. For this city and for every city and land, and for the faithful who dwell therein, for healthful seasons, for abundance of the fruits of the earth, and for peaceful times, let us pray to the Lord. For travelers by sea, by land, and by air, for the sick and the suffering, for captives and for their salvation, for those under persecution for the faith, for our deliverance from all tribulation, wrath, danger, and necessity, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy upon us, and protect us, O God, by your grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Calling to remembrance our all-holy Immaculate, most blessed and glorious Lady Theotokos, and ever-virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and all our life unto Christ our God.
Power and the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Thank you.
wisdom, stand upright.
Oh,
people and bless your inheritance. To you, O Lord, have I cried, O my God.
Wisdom.
Read it from St. Paul's letter to the Romans.
Let us attend.
Brethren, we who are strong ought to bear with the failings of the weak and not to please ourselves. Let each of us please his neighbor for his good to edify him. For Christ did not please himself, but as it is written, the reproaches of those who reproach thee fell on me. For whatever was written in former days was written for our instruction, that by steadfastness and by the encouragement of the scriptures we might have hope. May the God of steadfastness and encouragement grant you to live in such harmony with one another, in accord with Christ Jesus, that together we may with one voice glorify the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. Welcome one another, therefore, as Christ has welcomed you for the glory of God.
Said to him, Yes, Lord. Then Jesus touched their eyes, saying, According to your faith be it done to you. And their eyes were opened. And Jesus sternly charged them, See that no one knows it. But they went out of the way and spread his fame throughout all that district. As they were going away, behold, a dumb demoniac was brought to Jesus. And when the demon had been cast out, the dumb man spoke, and the crowds marveled, saying, Never was anything like this seen in Israel. But the Pharisees said, He casts out demons by the prince of demons. And Jesus went about all the cities and villages, teaching in their synagogues, and preaching the gospel of the kingdom, and healing every disease and every infirmity of the people.
Everything that you have for these monks who live in the desert in poverty. and they're not giving anything back to you. She started to take this to heart and started to let the thoughts really drive her. And soon she started shutting down her house to the monks. And one day when the monks came to spend their time there, they noticed that she was gone and the house was deserted. What had happened with this woman is that she was constantly provoked by her friends and those that she met at parties, to such a point that she joined a brothel and became a prostitute to earn her living. And when the monks found out about this, they were very sad and grieved, because they loved this lady so much. So the abbot of the monastery sent two monks out to the brothel to try to get her out and to coax her to leave. But when they came to the brothel doors, the woman who owned the brothel wouldn't let them in. And they finally begged her to at least let the woman know that they were there to talk to her. And the woman let the other woman know, the woman of the brothel that had left the monks and left her Christianity to become a prostitute, they let her know that the monks were there. And she said she didn't want to have anything to do with them. She had gone to such a point that she didn't even want to talk to the monks anymore. So the two monks went back to the monastery and reported to their abbot what had happened. The abbot left the monastery and he went to the brothel himself. And when he couldn't get in, he stripped himself of his monastic robe and he dressed himself as a civilian and he went to the brothel. And he paid money, and he asked the woman that owned the brothel if he can sleep with that woman that they knew that had left her home. So they put him in a room, and they ushered the girl in, and they shut the door. And as the girl began to take off her shoes, the abbot revealed who he was to her. And she broke down, and she wanted to leave with him right away. And they left, they walked away from the brothel, they walked out of the village, and they started to walk down the road to the monastery. Now night began to fall, because the monastery was quite a ways off, and the monk said to the woman, "I'll prepare you a place to sleep on this side of the road, and I'll sleep on the other side of the road, so that if any people come down the road, they won't be scandalized by a monk and a woman sleeping next to each other." So he prepared her a place to sleep, and he went to the other side of the road and walked off a little bit into the desert, into the distance, and he started to say his prayers. And when he finished his prayers, right before he was about to lay down and put himself to sleep, he saw a pillar of light over where the woman was laying, where he had prepared her bed. So the monk startled and didn't know what was going on. He ran over there, and he found the woman had died. So he decided to prepare her for burial. And in traditional monastic communities, in a lot of places in the world, the way that they bury the monks is that they take their robe, or their riasa, which you've probably seen clergy wear with really long sleeves. My kids like to call mine the Batman robe. And they wrap the monk in them, or the nun in them, and they sew up the garment, and they don't place them in a coffin, but just in the dirt. So since she wasn't a nun or anything, he removed his robes, and he started to prepare her for burial, and he started to sew up the garment from her head to her feet. And as he got to her feet, he noticed something very peculiar that he didn't notice before. And what he noticed was the outcome, or the proof, the living proof, of what we heard in the epistle today, the epistle reading from St. Paul to the Romans. Paul says, "For Christ did not please himself But it is written, the reproaches of those who reproached thee fell on me. That is, the reproaches that are due to all of us fell upon Christ. Now this monk, he was the abbot of the monastery. First of all, he didn't need to leave his monastery, but he did. He did not need to strip himself of the dignity of his priestly order or his monastic order and strip himself of his robes, but he did. He certainly didn't need to enter into a brothel, but he did. He certainly didn't need to travel with a woman and go outside of the city for her to seek repentance in the monastery. He didn't need to accompany her to that, but he did. He certainly didn't need to take off his robe and wrap her in it for burial, but he did. All the reproaches that were maybe due to this woman, maybe she deserved them, maybe not. But he took them all upon himself. Can you imagine the scandal of other people knowing that the monk, that an abbot of a monastery took off his robes and went into a brothel? But he did it anyways, out of the love for her. And St. Paul says, let each of us please his neighbor for his good to edify him. That is, to look upon the weak and those in our community and those in our lives who maybe don't have the help that they need and stoop and come to their level and sacrifice ourselves for them. This is what the monk did. He didn't need to do the things that he did, but he did them nonetheless because he loved the person of his community, even if she didn't live in the monastic cloister that they had, even if she wasn't a nun, right? She lived in the village, she lived in the world, but yet he still loved this person so much that he stripped himself of all the dignity that he had in order to come to her and save her. Christ, we hear from St. Paul also in Philippians that Christ emptied himself. God emptied himself to come to us, to save us. What the monk found when he came to the feet of this woman was that her feet were bloody and they were bruised and had scrapes all over them. His sacrifice for her filled her with so much love and repentance that the shoes that she took off in the room, she forgot and left behind. And she didn't complain one bit when they were walking on the desert road for all of these hours, all day long, listening to the monk talk about repentance and the kingdom of God. She didn't complain one bit about it. So the monk came to the realization himself that it didn't matter what theological things that he told her, or what arguments that he told her, or what great explanations about repentance, salvation, and moral arguments that he gave to her. It didn't matter. None of that mattered. What mattered was the self-emptying and becoming like Christ to take upon her burden that drove her with so much love that she was so overcome by that love that she didn't even feel the suffering of walking on the hot desert sand throughout the day. Christ-like love and self-emptying is the definition of community. It is what makes a community. It comes way before a beautiful building. It becomes way before beautiful vestments. It becomes something that comes way before the perfect location or the amount of people that are here or whatever. Sacrificing ourselves for our neighbors and emptying ourselves for our neighbors is what defines Christian community more than any other thing that we can think of, because it's how Christ accepted us. It's very interesting. On the priest's robe, on the priest's vestments, we have on the bottom of our epitrachelion fringes that hang down. And those fringes are supposed to remind us of all of the people that we hear confessions of, or all the people that we pastor, or all the people that we lead in the flock of Christ. And if you notice, it hangs down on our necks, and it's supposed to be like a yoke. It's our burden that we take on. We're supposed to be reminded that we take on the burden of the people. Now, this type of burden, none of us are exempt from, because we are all priests in our own right. And that burden to love one another and sacrifice ourselves for one another and take that burden on is something that we need to put on ourselves every day. I just have the blessing of having a garment that reminds me of it, but we need to be reminded of it every day, because this is how Christ accepted us. This is the definition of unity. It's a definition of community. St. Paul continues and he says, "May the God of steadfastness and encouragement grant you to live in such harmony with one another in accord with Jesus Christ, so that together you may with one voice glorify the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ." St. Paul does not just ask us to have one voice, but one mind. That means one will, one heart, and one goal: to be like him, to transform our lives into his, to decrease ourselves and our entire community so that Christ might increase and transform the community. It is not about having the perfect theology, although it's important. It's not about having a perfect building, although that's important. It's about transformation. Because theology is not just book learning, but it is the actual experience of God. Correct theology is the experience of God. The Holy Fathers and those in our church that paved the way for the traditions that we carry and that we hold today, they didn't just write theology because they were smart people. They wrote theology because they experienced God, because they emptied themselves and took on the mind of God. Finally, St. Paul says, welcome one another. In some translations it says, accept one another. Therefore, as Christ has welcomed or accepted you for the glory of God. And just to think about that a little bit, how did Christ accept us? Christ accepted us during false trials and lies and accusations. Christ accepted us through malice and smitings. Christ accepted us on the whipping post, bound, naked, ashamed. Christ accepted us with arms out upon the cross. Christ accepted us when a lance was put into his side, when a sponge was offered to him on a reed. Christ accepted us when those below him said, he said he'd save us, but he cannot save himself. So we are to accept each other, accept one another from our own cross, that is crucified. And when people make lies and accusations toward us, it's very, very easy for us to turn our backs on people, even if they brush us the wrong way, they walk past us the wrong way, God forbid they look at us the wrong way. It's very easy to neglect people and to go into our own corners in our own lives. But that is not self-emptying, and that is not community. May God, through the prayers of St. Paul and through his words, enable us to empty ourselves and take upon the burden of our neighbor, and therefore, through self-emptying and taking upon that burden, develop a transformative life in Christ and a transformative community to the glory of His holy name, the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
I don't know if I'm right for me.
all of you. May the Lord God remember in his kingdom, always, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Sophia, Lucas, and Ruth, for Deacon Tom and Wendy, for Creelan, for Serena, for Taylor,
Michelle, Lori, Lauren, Stephanie, Claire, Christina, Mary, Kelsey, and Caitlin, that they have mercy, life, peace, health, salvation, visitation, pardon, and remission of their sin. Lord God, remember them in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages. For the Orthodox servants of God departed this life, especially for Stephanie, for Joshua, and for Abigail, the Lord God, remember them in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Guide, a guardian of our souls and bodies, Let us ask of the Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
Pardon and remission of our sins and transgressions, all things good and profitable for our souls, and for peace in the world. Let us ask of the Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
That we may complete the remaining time of our life in peace and repentance, a Christian ending to our life, painless, blameless, peaceful, and a good defense before the awesome judgment seat of Christ. Let us ask of the Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
Calling to remembrance our all-holy immaculate, blessed and glorious Lady Theotokos and ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and all our life unto Christ our God. That with one accord we may confess.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, thou Trinity, one in essence, and undivided.
Christ is in our midst.
He is in our midst.
Christ is in our midst.
God opens the doors in wisdom, let us attend.
I believe one God, Father Almighty, Maker of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and Christ, the Son of God, the only begotten, begotten of the Father before all worlds, light of light, very God of very God, begotten not made, of one essence with the Father, by whom all things were made, who for us men, and for our salvation, came down from heaven, and was incarnate of the Holy Spirit, and the Virgin Mary, and was made man, and was crucified also for us under Pontius Pilate, and suffered and was buried, and the third day he rose again, according to the Scriptures, and ascended into heaven, and sits at the right hand of the Father, and he shall come again with glory to judge the living and the dead, whose kingdom shall have no end. And I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord and giver of life, who proceeds from the Father, who with the Father and the Son together is worshipped and glorified, spoke by the prophets, and I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I acknowledge the baptism of remission of sins. I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Let us stand aright, let us stand with fear. Let us attend that we may offer the holy oblation in peace.
Our mercy
and
peace of sacrifice of praise.
Of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Mother God, the Father, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with thy Spirit.
Let us lift up our hearts.
We lift them up unto the Lord.
Let us give thanks unto the Lord.
It is meet and right to worship the Father, Son and the Holy Spirit, the Trinity, one in essence and undivided,
invisible, incomprehensible, ever existent, and eternally the same. Thou, my only begotten Son, and thy Holy Spirit, thou who it was who just bring us from our existence into thee. And when we had fallen away, just raise us up again, and this not cease, do all things and help on us, brought us back together, and has endowed us with the kingdom which is to come. For all these things we give thanks to thee and to thy only begotten Son, and thy Holy Spirit, for all things of which we know and of which we love, and for all the benefits bestowed upon us, both manifest and unseen. And we give thanks unto thee also for this ministry which custom, thou safe to receive at our hands everyone. Even though we stand beside thee, thousands of archangels and 10,000 of angels, the cherubim and the seraphim, six wings, many eyes, sword of light, born on their fingers, singing the triumph of the air, shouting proclaiming and singing.
Oh.
all the saints again and again in peace. Let us pray to the Lord. For the precious gifts which have been offered and sanctified, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
That our God, who loveth mankind, receiving them upon his holy heavenly and ideal altar, for an order of spiritual fragrance, will send them upon his maker his divine grace and the gift of the Holy Spirit, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Asking for the unity of the faith and the communion of the Holy Spirit, let us commend ourselves to each other and our whole life in Christ our God.
Holy things are good, the holy.
Holy is holy, my God. Thank you.
O God, save thy people and bless thine inheritance.
Holy, peaceful, and sinless.
Let us commend ourselves to each other and our whole life to you, Christ our God.
Some people always know just the right thing to say.
We would like to embarrass the heck out of Christina by asking her to come up here and join her husband. You know, she's been kind of sitting in the background, but she's really been waiting for this moment. Or maybe it would be better if you just went over there and stand with her. But we'd like to sing many years to you guys. Like most of Maria, she really is reluctant to get the limelight. Hey, kid, you can't smoke in church.
A cigar.
Always in that song. Oh God, grant your servants peaceful and prosperous life, good health, salvation, and preserve them for many
My term is up, and I will not be returning to parish council. So, lucky you. Okay. Then you might want to go to your email settings and unblock me, because I will be sending that email out. And later on, you can block me.
Thank you. against us.